Well, students, today what we will do? Today we will do the histograms. Okay, histograms in data visualization. What is histogram? Histogram is actually a bar chart showing the frequency distribution. Okay, in this case, what will happen? The data is grouped into ranges such as 100 to 999, 200 to 300, 300 to 400, in that way. Okay, and then plotted as bars based on the frequency values. The range is also known as the beans, BINS, beans. All right, that is the thing. So let me share the screen and then we will go with the practical activity. Okay, that is the thing. We will go with the practical activity as well. Okay, that is the thing. Understood? So then the width of the bars in the histogram shows the beans and y-axis will show the frequency. Fine. Y-axis will show what? Y-axis will show the frequency. All right, that is the thing. So now what is happening here? Okay, the similar to the bar graph, it is actually, what does it mean? It says that it is similar to bar graph. Okay, there is no difference between the bar graph and the thing is that, but it takes place with the help of the frequency. Okay, but with the difference that in a histogram each bar is for a range of data. Okay, so that means with the bean values only, whatever be the series will be generated. Fine. So the width of the bars corresponds to the class intervals, with the height of each bar corresponds to the frequency of the class it represents. Okay, suppose the frequency is 5, then the between 20 to 30 range, suppose there are 5 values, then the bar height of the bar also will be 5 only. So in that case, we can understand that how many such type of data is existing or are existing in that certain range. Okay, so let us go to the Python program once. So here is a problem in Python. Okay, so it has been closed. Okay, just a minute. So let us open it once again. Okay, and then we will see the histogram. Okay, that is the thing. It's clear. So suppose here what we are actually doing out here, you see, just I'm going to the notepad once in order to make you understand what is actually the thing to be done. Okay, so here say a histogram as per the scores and all, suppose say 20 to 25. Okay, suppose this is to 20 to 25. Suppose we are having how many data? Say for example, I'm sorry, it will be 20 to 25. There are maybe the 3 data is available. And then say 26 to 30, suppose we are having how many data? Say for example, say 1 data. Okay, 1 data. And then say 31 to 35, suppose say we are having how many data? Say 2 data. And then say 36 to 40, what will happen? 36 to 40, then we will happen no data. There are no data. And say 41 to 45, how many are there? Say for example 1 data. And then 46 to 50, we are having how many data? 46 to 50, we are having say only 4 data. Okay, so this is the way, this are actually the distribution. So this data is called frequency distribution table. What is this called? The data. Okay, the data. Okay, the data is called, I'm sorry, where it is going, the data is called, the what called the frequency distribution table. Okay, distribution table. Okay, so on the basis of that, the data ranges are being selected and accordingly that to be done. Okay, that is the thing. So now what is happening? To construct a histogram, the first step is to bean the range of values. Bean means to put the to fix the series, and that divide the entire range of values into a series of intervals. Okay, these beans may or may not be have the same interval size. Then count how many values fall into each interval. Okay, like see here, the bean values are not same. 1 and 3, 1 is 1, 1 is 2, 1 is 0, another is 1, another is 4. Okay, the beans are usually non-overlapping intervals of a variable. That is the thing. So what are the beans? Okay, so beans in a histogram, histogram are usually non-overlapping. Okay, non-overlapping intervals, okay, of a variable. Okay, clear? Beans in a histogram are usually non-overlapping intervals. Okay, non-overlapping intervals of a variable. That is the thing. Okay, so now let us draw the histogram once. Okay, you can clear the histogram. So just going to the file. Okay, that is the thing. Understood? So here in the previous case, or what will happen in the previous case, histogram will be having the ranging from whatever things we have given. On the basis of that, we are making in fact the thing is okay. So we are just importing here. Okay, so the matplotlib. Okay, import matplotlib. Okay, matplotlib.pyplot. Okay, pyplot. Okay, as plt. Fine, as plt. Then we are taking some data out here. Data is what? Say I'm taking 20 comma 30 comma 45 comma 32 comma 34. Okay. 34, okay, 24, 25. So values can be taken haphazardly, but as per the things, then accordingly the values will be fixed into the range. Okay, that is in the frequency distribution. Okay, and 48, and then we are taking out here 50, 48, 50, then 50, then again 49. Okay, so these are the values that we have taken. Okay, data. All right, that is the thing. Clear. Okay, so now what we are taking the bean values by taking a bean only, the variable as bean, as well the variable bean is actually keyword. We are taking beans like this, and then we are taking what, 20, and then say we are taking out here 26, okay, out here, and then say 31. So taking the difference of 5, okay, then 36 41 36 41, and then say 46 out here. So these are the bean values that we have taken. Fine. Okay, so now the thing is that when we will draw the plot the chart, okay, so what is happening, plt.hist, okay, plt.hist, and then what we will do out here, we will first of all give the data, okay, data, then we will give the beans equals to b. So just a minute, beans is actually taking b only out here. Beans is equals to what, b, okay, beans is equals to what, it's a keyword actually, b, okay, and then we will take color equals to say red. Okay, we are taking red out here, and then say level, level equals to say marks. Okay, that is the thing. So we will take out here marks. Okay, clear, marks, marks. Okay, label, sorry, not le, label. Okay, that is the level attribute. We are taking the marks out here. Okay, so that is the thing. Yes, marks. Okay, and then closing the this thing, plt.hst. okay, so here the double quote and single quote all the same, because you know Python cannot distinguish between the single quote and double quote. Then what is happening, so whatever you give, you, it will be taken as the single quote only, but don't mix it up. Don't give one place in single quote, another place double quote. Don't in that way, either of the one. Okay, if you are opening with double quotes, you have to close it also with double quotes, and if you are opening with single quote, you have to close it also with single quote. Okay, that is the thing. So very effective coding is this one. Okay, so it will just teach you how to draw a histogram, okay, which is in the syllabus, okay, in the curriculum. Okay, that is the thing. So now plt.xlevel equals to student marks. Okay, x level you have to fix on same thing, LBL level. Okay, so then, okay, marks of students. Okay, marks of students. Okay, students. Fine. And then what else we have to do, we have to do the plt.ylevel, plt.ylevel, ylevel. Okay, and then say marks of marks of what, so no, here it is frequency, I'm sorry, frequency, frequency, clear. That is the thing. So this is over. Okay, now plt.legend. Okay, plt.legend. Okay, we will fix up plt.legend. Okay, and then what else to do, what else to do, plt.show. plt.show means what, it will just show the plot. Okay, plt.show. okay, so now close this one. Okay, out here, and then say run. Okay, so then we will just give the things out here, run module, and then we will save it. Afterwards the execution will take place. Fine. So here what will happen in this case, let's see the thing. So why what kind of things are coming out here. Okay, then we can analyze it. Okay, that is the thing. Now let us see out here the size of the histogram. Okay, and then say we are giving the name of this type, the name is actually hist. Okay, hist, say 3 we are giving. Okay, so now we are just giving save. Okay, so now let us see that how these things are being taking place. Okay, so it will be shown in a separate window if no errors are there. Okay, so I hope there is no typographical mistake. Okay, so the output will be generated within a short while. All right, that is the thing. Clear. So now we have to analyze that what are the different ranges are they available. Okay, that is the thing, so we can understand it easily. And here the thing is that, okay, so first of all let us open this one and see how many frequencies and what was there. Okay, so we have kept it out here already along with the values. Then we will check it out here whether the graph is correct or not, because 36 to 40 range no values have been given, so that expected to be a gap. Okay, and 20 to 25 there are 3 are there, so the frequency height of the frequency bar should reach up to 3. Okay, so now let us see what is happening. Yes, expected this one. Okay, so by seeing the data series you can expect also what will be the outcome. Okay, so let it bring it this side and then analyze the value. Okay, let's see now. Okay, 20, so here are 3 are there. Okay, 20 to 25 3 are there, 26 to 30 1 are there. Okay, so 1 is there, 26 to 30. From here to here you can see 26 to 30, and then 31 to 35 there are 2 values, so it has come over here. So this is the frequency and this is the Y level marks of students. Okay, that is the thing. So we have not given any title out here, and then the next range 36 to 40 no values have been there, no values have been printed. Okay, so and then 41 to 45 there is only 1 value, so 1 has come, and then 45 onwards also 1 value, so it has shown it the height quite correctly, so that is 1. Okay, so that is the thing. So 46 to 50 actually how many values we are having? 46 to 50 actually we have taken here 1 value, but here actually in the original list it is supposed to be 1 actually. By mistake we have taken so 1 value. Okay, that is the thing. So here it is only 1 value, because the 49 is the only value that is there in our program. Okay, let's see, open the program once and then see how many values are there. Yes, okay, so 49. Okay, no, 4 values are there only. Okay, 48 and then say onwards, and then 49, and then 50 has been generated. Let's see now what is actually the problem. Okay, so the thing is that 40, why it is showing 1, that we need to see why it is showing this one. Okay, that is the thing. So none of the value has been reached over here. 41 and then 45 is showing out here 1 value. Okay, that is the thing. So up to 1 it is showing actually, because the data range actually been set up in that way only. That is the thing. Okay, so after that what is happening, we have taken only 46. So after 46 these values are having no this thing. So 41 to 46 only the last range has been fixed, so the 50 and all has not been taken into consideration. Okay, in the list. Okay, 50 and all has not been taken into consideration. That's why once more I am just executing, you see it's this thing. After 46 only, that's why because the last range is actually 46. So now we are just increasing the range here. Actually I am taking out here also 46, then what is the next range? 51 we are taking. Then you can understand the difference. Okay, so in the last one what is actually there, that has not been considered because the frequency range was out of range. Okay, the beans was in out of range. Now let's see, then you can analyze it nicely. Okay, 45 to 50. Okay, so here it is showing only 1. Okay, that is the thing. Just a minute, so let it come once, then we can analyze it. Okay, just a minute, what has been shown? 1 minute. It has appeared now. Now let us see what is actually there. Okay, so here the 50 49. So 46 actually there are only 1 value, that is 45 here it is. Okay, and then 48 50 50 49 there are 4 values are here, but that has not been shown. We have taken up to 45 only. Okay, so no other thing has been taken. Now we have increased this range to what? 46 to, we are just increasing to range 51. Let's see now what is happening. Okay, so in that case we will be able to understand our analysis. Okay, that is the thing. So let us execute it once more and then see what is actually being happening. Okay, that is the thing. So let's see. So afterwards we will do one more program. First of all we need to see that what are the things are there, then different type of controls are there, that we will see once again. Okay, so by checking it. Okay, that is the thing. Clear? The same program, let's see now. Where it is. Okay, let's see now. It will appear right now. Okay, and then similar things we will show, similar things we will keep. We will just add one control in the next program. Okay, first let us analyze it. Okay, that is the thing. So it is taking time, it will take some time because the library to be generated first. Okay, library to appear first, so it has come out here. Now let us see the histogram, so how it looks like, and then you can understand easily. Okay, so you see now it has become 4 now, as we had increased the range. Okay, we have kept last time up to 45, that's why it was showing only 1. Okay, that is correct, but the next term, what is happening out here? So next range onwards, what is happening? There are 4 values. What are those? That is 250s, and I think 48 and 49 is also there. Okay, available. Okay, let's see now over here the values, then you can understand it easily. Okay, so here we are having the 4 values, 48, 50, 50 and 49. So for that reason, what is happening, the histogram has reached 4. Okay, that is the thing. So that is the frequency bar is showing the 4 values of that certain range. That means what? 46 to 51, there are 4 values. So that's why the frequency bar also rested at 4. So that in this way you have to understand. So whenever you will take the value, you always consider the first value and last value, and accordingly you take your beans. Accordingly you take your beans. It is not like that you have to take the difference of 5. You can take some other difference also as well. You can take the difference of 6, 6 and all. Okay, but the frequency bar will show its accordingly whatever be the value is falling within the particular range. Okay, that is the thing. So I hope you understand this one. Okay, now you see that we will just take one another control out here, that is called edge color. Okay, what is this edge color? EDGE edge color. Okay, equals to, I'm taking out here, say black. Okay, black I am taking, so I can understand. Okay, so because black color always have a contrast. Okay, that's the thing. So now let us run it. Okay, and then see what is exactly being happening. Okay, so this is the edge color control. Okay, so all the things will remain same. Okay, only the edge color is supposed to be changed. Okay, that is the thing. So in this way you can easily vary. Okay, one particular thing. So it's an idle LS. So idle, I have to go back for the things. Okay, and then it will come back once. Wait, the histogram has not been initialized, that's why the idle error has appeared. Okay, so that is the thing. So in this way you can easily create histograms by simply by issuing this command only, nothing else. What is the main command out here? plt.hist. okay, and then you have to give the data, then you have to give the beans, then you have to give the color, okay, of the histogram. Okay, you can give any color, blue, black, green, whatsoever, and edge color I have added in order to add the edges. But however, the edge color is not compulsory, it is not mandatory. Okay, edge color can be of anything. Okay, that is the thing. Edge color, if you are not giving, then also okay. If you are giving, then also okay. So edge color has been created. Now it is not bare formatted, so there is an edge with this particular histogram. Okay, what are the things are there? Here you can see, and this is the legend has already been created with marks, and here is the edge also being formed, framed over here. Okay, now let us do another program of histogram. Okay, by taking the different data sets. Okay, now we are going over here, then file, and then choosing new. After new file to be opened, and then say we are just creating here import. Okay, matplotlib dot pyplot. Okay, pyplot as plt. Okay, as plt, fine. Okay, next is what? Data. We are taking few data out here. Then 40, 60, then 55, 20, 35, 70, 60 once more. Okay, 89, 20, 89, 20, 33. Okay, so 20 is the least value out here, and then 89 is the largest value out here. So we are fixing the beans out here, that right from the things B. Okay, equals to just we are taking 0, and then say 33, and then say 45. Okay, 0 to 33, 33 to 45. Okay, and then say 60. Okay, so and then say 100. Okay, so these are the things has been taken out here. So this is also a kind of bin out here we have taken, 45 to 60, then 60 to 100 in that way. Okay, that is the thing. So 20, 40, 60, 80, and 100, in that way the histogram will be framed, and then whatever values are falling within that particular range will be displayed, fine. So now let us plot it, plt.hist. okay, and then what we are giving out here, what we are giving out here, same thing, data, and then say beans. Okay, data in beans, and then say color, and then we are taking out here green. Okay, green colored. Okay, and then say edge color edg edge color color equals, we are taking out here blue. Okay, so that is the thing. So we are taking out here blue. Okay, and then say closing this one. We are not giving anything out here, we are just giving plt dot show. Okay, so here it is an error. Okay, as compiler suggested me out here. Sorry, the interpreter has suggested the same, and then say click on show. Okay, you're not giving any title or something like that. Okay, so just we are giving, this is very easy program actually. Okay, in order to frame, only the thing is that you have to decide the proper bean values. Okay, that is the thing. Clear? So now what is happening here? Okay, so the thing is that what we are doing out here, giving the name hist4. Okay, that is the thing. So now click on save and then see what is going to happen. Clear? So first of all, let us see, let the output to come. So now how the output to come over here? First of all, the scaling will be done from 0 to 20, 20, 40, 60, 80 and 100. Okay, accordingly the values also will be displayed. You have to count the number of values that you have taken, how many 20s are there, how many 40s are there, so 20 to 40 how many values are there. So everything will be calculated in that way. Okay, so sometimes the ranges are not showing in the histogram in its proper place. What the thing is that, so beans is not defined. Okay, let me check out what is the problem out here. Beans is not defined means here is the error. Okay, beans equals to B I have to take. Okay, otherwise the beans has not been fixed, the histogram could not be formed. That is the error actually has been generated. Okay, so I have checked it and I had given the beans out here. Now the histogram will be formed. Okay, that is the thing. Now let us see that how it is functioning, how the histogram has been appearing. Okay, that is very very important. All right. Now let us see that how it is appearing, and then we will see it. The thing is that how many number of values are there in each. Okay, so we have to decide it in that way. If you see the data set, you can easily understand it. And then this is the way actually you see the 0 to 20, as I have told, 60, 80 and 100 it has been printed. So 80 to 100 it is showing the four values. Okay, 80 to 100 you see out here, not actually in fact, so it has been 60 to 100. Okay, 60 to 100 it is showing four values. Okay, 60, 89 and 60 once more, and then 70 is also appearing. Fine. So that's why the four values are appearing in the data set. So that's why the frequency bar has taken place into four only. Okay, that is the 60 to 100. Okay, and then what, 33, 0 to 33. Okay, 0 to 33 will be somewhere over here. Then 33 to 45 over here. So you can see it actually. Okay, and then 45 to 60 will be here and 60 to 100 will be here. If you are taking the data sets and the data values and you are calculating, in that case you can see that the length of the frequency bar. Okay, and then you can understand it very well. Okay, so here it is 0 to 20 and then so 0 to 33 actually, 0 to 33 actually, and then 33 to 45 will be somehow over here, and it is showing three value. You calculate over here 33 to 45, how many values are there, you can find over here the three values only. Okay, that is the thing. So the histogram has been formed. Okay, quite accurately. There is no problem in framing the histogram. All right, that is the thing. So now the histogram, as I have described here with you, so two different histogram we had seen by using two different data values. You can see out here, these are the two different histograms. Okay, only the extra control that we have used, that is the edge color control. Okay, rest of the things are fine. Okay, that is the problem. That is not the problem. Okay, that is the thing. So these are the things that you need to remember whenever you are doing the histogram. Okay, so here we have not given the, only the difference with the last program is what, x level and y level we have not given. We have not given any legend, nothing. But plt.show is a very important command. Without this, the graph or the chart or the histogram, whatever you say, will not be executed. So the line graph, if you say the line graph, if you say the bar graph, if you say the scatter, if you say the pie chart, so at the end of every graph you have to give this plt.show, otherwise the graph will not be initiated. Okay, so graph will not be created. Graph will be created, but it will not be shown to you. The output will not be will not be shown to you. That is the thing. So this is one program, okay, of histogram. Fine. So now let us see some more we can do also. We can do another program also with the histogram. These are the very easy program actually. That is the thing. So edge color black and all that we have done. Okay. What we are doing out here, we are not giving any bean. Then let us see that how the beans are being distributing. Okay. Import matplotlib, matplotlib dot pyplot. Okay, pyplot, this is the very fundamental command as plt. Okay, that is the thing. Clear? So we are doing it, and then what we'll do, we'll just take data. Okay, we'll just take the data and we will take 40 comma 60 comma 55, same set of data 55, then 20 comma 30 comma 35 comma 35 comma 70 60 70 and then 60 comma 89 comma 20 comma 33. Okay, these are the data values we have taken. Now we are just doing without the bins, plt dot hist. Okay, just what we are doing out here, data has been taken and then comma and then say color equals to green we are giving. Okay, green, all right, color green, and then say h color black, huh, edg h color lower color equals to blue we will give. Okay, blue. Okay, so that is the thing, and then so just closing it. Okay, so what will happen in this case, it will make 10 equal bins from the data given to it automatically. Okay, clear, 10 different bins. So how many values are there? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 difference. Okay, so 0 to 20 will be created, 20 to 30 will be created, 30 to 40 will be created, and 40 to 50 will be created, and wherever there is no value, okay, in that case what will happen, in that case there will be no frequency bar can be found. Okay, that is the thing. So you can see it very nicely what has been given out here, 40 to 50, I think between 40 to 50 there are no values. Okay, that is the thing. So now you see out here how the datagram to be the histogram to be framed. Okay, plt dot we are just giving what show. Okay, so then it will be over. Okay, so that is the thing. So it is actually the so what is the thing, so what should I write, so no bins, so histogram without bin values. Okay, bins value. Okay, bins value. Okay, so what will happen, so here, so 10 equal bins will be created. Okay, bins will be created. Okay, 10 equal bins will be created. Okay, that will happen by default actually, so whenever you will not mention the bins. Okay, and then say there are 10 values, so the 10 bins will be created. Okay, run module and then click on OK. Fine, so let us see now how the histogram will be framed. Okay, so wherever the values will be there, no frequency bar will be there. Okay, that is the thing. So now let us see now, give the name. Okay, hist I'm giving here 5. Okay, that is the thing. Okay, so now see the output of this particular program. Okay, how this is appearing. Fine, then you will understand it better. Let the output to come, then we can analyze the values. Okay, so whatever be the range. Okay, so 0 to 20 no values, so that place will remain blank. Okay, that is the things. And 40 to 50 there are no values, and 60 to 70 no values. Okay, and then 70 to 80 there are, I think the one value is appearing. Okay, and then again 80 to 90 one values are appearing. Okay, that is the thing. You see that as expected, 0 to 20 no values are there, and two values are there between 20 to 30, so that has been appeared. So 20 to 30 if we are taking 20 there are two values are there. Okay, 33 is actually going to the next range. Okay, so that is what over there. Okay, that is the thing. So and then as expected, 60 to 70 no values are there. Okay, between 60 to 70 and between 80 to 90 there is one value and one has been there. Okay, and then 50 to 60 there are three values have been appeared. Okay, 55 60 and then another 60 is also there. Okay, so there are three values, so the histogram has been made with the frequency bar that is showing us 3. Okay, the height of 3 it is showing us. So the thing is that if you are doing it practically, if you are doing its practical implementation, then easily you can understand how you are framing the bins and all. Okay, so that is the thing. So 1 1 2 3 4, okay, here 5 6 7 8, okay, and 9 and 10. Okay, so that is the thing. So 10 bins have been created. So here can say 3, okay, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Don't take it. Okay, don't consider it. Only this thing. 1, 2, 3, here 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. 10 bins are being framed. Okay, 10 equal bins. Okay, that is the thing. So in this way, you will do the thing is that in this way, you will do the data frame. Fine, so now I'm just checking out here what will happen if I'm just doing the bin values. I'm modifying the bin values out here to 5. Okay, so then what will happen, so I'm just taking out here bins and then I am just declaring it bins equals to 5. Okay, then what will happen, 5 bins will be created, and then you see how the data frame will change. Okay, that's the thing. Clear, with bin values, histogram with bin values. Okay, so I'm sorry, so here I will just remove this one. Okay, just you see it how these things are appearing. Okay, run module and then say click on OK. So what will happen? 5 equal bins will be created with the certain range, and the same data set will be displayed, and the same frequency bar will be displayed, but this time they will not be away. Okay, so they will be closer to each other. Okay, this time, because I have already selected the 5 bins out here, so and automatically the series will be created. Okay, that is the thing. Clear? Now you see that from where it is starting. Okay, so 0 to 20, there is a gap, definitely the gap will be there, and other bins will be close to each other, means attached to each other as a normal histogram being formed. Okay, that is the thing. All right, so now let us wait for a while, it will be appearing. Okay, so this is actually what happens if we specify the number of bins we want to create. You see here the 5 has been created. Okay, so the with the similar range, okay, it will be range has been calculated, and accordingly the values are also being calculated. Okay, same one size one has been come, same 3 size has come. Okay, so there will be no change at all. Okay, so it will be automatically adjusted. Fine, so you no need to bother for it, but you have to see that how the bin values are being framed, and what are the different frequency and what is the height of the frequency bar. These 3 things you have to see in your histogram. So what are the key points? It mentions about the bins, it mentions the sequence of integers, it is an optional argument to the hist. Hist means like you can remove this also, the bins, and when not mentioned, Python by default creates 10 bins, remember, of equal range from the data given. It takes the lowest value and the highest value from the data and divide the range into 10 equal slots. Okay, that is the thing. And if bins is mentioned, okay, then it will have suppose you have mentioned is 11 15 20 and 30, then it will have 3 bins, that is one less than the number of values you have specified. Okay, so how many number of values? Suppose you have given 5 values, the 4 bins will be created. Okay, not like not more than that. Okay, so that is the thing. So we can also specify the number of bins we need by writing bins equals to n. Okay, so that one can be taken by using the int input also. Okay, that is the thing. So these are the following points that what I had told at the end. Okay, those are actually the important points about the bins. Okay, that is the thing. Understood? So in this way you will be able to create the histogram. So at the end I would like to say that practical implementation of this kind of programs are very much required, and you must do it. Okay, that is the thing. So then only you can understand the how the values are being plotted. So I have shown you today few programs. Okay, that is actually on histogram, and I hope you understand these programs, and once more you just try to practice this one and clear practice this one. Okay, in your Python language idle interface. Okay, and then see the outcome with the different data sets. Okay, that is the things that I would like to show you at the end. All right, thank you students, stay safe.